Thank you, Hartley, for your kind introduction and for your strong words and your ongoing strong support, not just of Assiniboine Park, but of Winnipeg, of Manitoba, and of Canada. Your thoughtful influence, leadership, and strength is really appreciated. And on behalf of all Manitobans and Canadians, I say thank you.
Merci aussi pour l'esprit d'initiative dont vous avez fait preuve, Margaret. Et merci à toute l'équipe de conservation du Parc Assiniboine qui nous rassemble autour de nous aujourd'hui.
I have to say, last night I was at the opening of the Canada Summer Games here in Winnipeg, and the energy I saw there from these young athletes gathered across the country here in Winnipeg, excited to be here, excited to make new friends and mostly push themselves to their limits and beyond, was extremely heartwarming, not just for the great games we're going to have, but for the great future we have in which those young people are not just leaders of tomorrow, but already leaders today. And I know that as we think about moving forward in ways that serve them, that serve the future, extraordinary announcements and opportunities like this are all about investing in the future that those young people, and indeed all young people gathered here today and across the city, are going to appreciate and benefit from for years to come.
Je suis très content aussi d'être ici avec la vice-première ministre Stephenson et le maire Bowman. C'est des alliés, c'est des amis, c'est des gens qui savent que de travailler fort pour les communautés, de travailler en partenariat, c'est au cœur de ce que les Canadiens s'attendent de nous et de pouvoir toujours mettre l'emphase sur le fait qu'ensemble, nous avons la capacité d'accomplir de grandes choses, c'est essentiel. Et parlant d'accomplir des grandes choses ensemble, c'est toujours un plaisir pour moi d'être accompagné par notre incroyable équipe de députés de Winnipeg, Dan Vandal, Doug Elfson, Jim Carr, Kevin Lammerer, Marianne Mihaichuk, and Terry Duguid.
Thank you very much, guys, for everything you're doing, all your hard work representing your communities in Ottawa. I also want to thank Elder Hall for his prayer and his leadership, and thank you very much for sharing your beautiful voice with us this morning.
On a avec vous aujourd'hui une équipe qui travaille d'arrache-pied tous les jours pour bâtir des communautés plus fortes.
So as we gather on traditional Treaty One territory and the ancestral home of the Métis Nation, I want to offer a special thanks to the Indigenous leaders who've come before us, to Elder Hall, and to all of everyone who realizes that reconciliation is about, yes, recognizing the terrible mistakes of the past, but moving forward in true partnership as we build a stronger future for everyone, and that it involves Indigenous peoples and governments, yes, of course, but also essentially non-Indigenous Canadians to be part of it. And I thank you all for the spirit of reconciliation that, as Brian pointed out, is so strong right here in Winnipeg. Because we're reminded that no matter who we are or where we're from, we need to respect the land upon which we live and that we share. We need to appreciate it, give thanks for it, and think about the ways that the land connects us, person to person, culture to culture. And that's why I'm happy to announce today that the federal government will be joining forces with the province of Manitoba, the city of Winnipeg, and many, many private donors to help bring Canada's diversity gardens to life. La contribution fédérale, qui pourra atteindre 35 millions de dollars, aide à achever le réaménagement du parc Assiniboine de Winnipeg, de la feuille, qui attire l'attention sur la biodiversité, au jardin des nations autochtones, où les Canadiens de partout peuvent apprendre à mieux connaître ceux qui ont été les premiers à prendre soin du territoire. Our investment of up to $35 million will help complete the redevelopment of Winnipeg's Assiniboine Park, from the leaf, with its focus on biodiversity, to the Indigenous People's Garden, where Canadians from all backgrounds can learn about and learn from the original caretakers of this land. This investment will help support local businesses that rely on tourism and create more good, well-paying jobs for the middle class and those working hard to join it. But more than that, Canada's Diversity Gardens will be a place where visitors can connect with nature and with each other, where old friends can meet, and where new friends can be found. That's how we build stronger communities. So finally,
Finally, I want to especially thank all the private donors who are here today and who helped make Canada's diversity gardens possible. Obviously, governments have a very important role to play in this project and in other large projects that we know will benefit so many people. But there is no substitute for local action, local engagement, and local leadership. Thank you for caring so deeply about your community, and thank you for sharing your park and, soon, its new, beautiful diversity gardens with all of Canada.